It's 2020 and the start of a new year. So today's topic is going to be about being intentional in our marriage. And here with me is Sarah, who's our contributing writer for Comma, in case you didn't know, and her husband Jason. They've been married for 3 years now, and this is going into their fourth year of marriage. So let's see, what does being intentional about your marriage look like to the both of you? How are you doing it?
We started just last year practicing goal setting. So we take some time off throughout the year, or actually at the beginning of the year, just to share what each of us envision the year to be, or what we would like to see more of in our lives.
Probably set goals for our finances, upskilling, learning new creative stuff, probably from like master classes that we can get online, and documentaries, personal development and all that.
Relationships with people.
Yeah.
Giving, like how much can we not just give financially, but of our time to others as well.
Yeah.
And I think it helps because when we have that space to share what's on our minds, maybe he's got some goals for the year that he would like to achieve for himself. At least I'm aware of it. And throughout the year, I can keep supporting him or reminding him, and he can do the same for me. And that way, we're achieving our individual goals, but together as a team.
Great. So what are the things that is related to your goal setting for this year that you have discussed about? And what are some of the challenges that you face?
We sometimes procrastinate a lot.
Yeah, procrastinate.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think it's quite a normal thing to do. I think most people procrastinate a lot in life, right?
Yeah. I think with technology now, we are quite distracted with technology. With our phones, with Instagram or whatever, we are just busy there, and then we forgot. We're distracted with life, with things going on. So it's like, okay, today maybe this week we'll take time to do some, like watch the masterclass, but then we're like, oh, okay, things are happening, or family coming, or that. But, like, things like this, like, okay, maybe we do it next week. So next week become next month becomes like, yeah, it's already end of the year.
So what could have helped was having somebody, writing it down.
Writing it down, which we did.
Yeah, you did write it down.
We did write it down.
But you just didn't check it.
Yeah, we didn't check it. And we forgot to stick it up on a wall.
I think writing things down is a really good way of trying to remember stuff. Because like when you say things, sometimes we just easily forget what we say. Yeah, and being accountable and having a checkpoints at the middle of every quarter or something like that is a great.
And having friends to go through it.
Maybe you can also have friends who encourage you together. So let's say if your friends have similar goals with you, I have a chat group with two other couples of mine. We call it our marriage accountability group. And so over there, we will always remind ourselves, hey, have you guys gone on dates this week yet? Or like, did you go and do a father-son date or something like that? So we will mention it, and then we will say like, oh, this week we did this, So it just kind of like triggers everybody, oh yeah, we didn't do any of those things. So I think like it helps a lot to have that kind of friendships that you can do life together. So anything that you want to say to the people out there?
Start on something, discuss with your partner in what you want to accomplish in your marriage together. I guess simple things like probably if you start a workout or sign up for a gym membership or whatever like this. Find things that work together and have same interests, and probably learn off each other as well.
Wow, I love that. Thank you so much for sharing everything. May 2020 be an awesome year for the both of you. Yes!